Midway through the first season, around episode 14, our domestic distributors, LBS, Henry and Paul Siegel, went bankrupt. No one in the industry was particularly surprised at their departure, nor did anyone mourn their event. Upon the demise of LBS, All American decided to expand their company's focus. Now, not only would they guarantee the show, but they would also become the domestic distributors of Baywatch. It seemed like a natural evolution for them. They owned the copyright, they had arranged cash flow facilities. If they owned the distribution rights, they would control another pivotal piece of the whole formula. Distribution at the time was a relatively low-risk business, and the profits could be staggering. But All American's first duty to Baywatch was to serve as the guarantors. By this time, we had spent all of Fremantle's foreign advance money, which was $400,000 times 22, in making the first 14 episodes. All American, however, was not yet receiving its advertising revenues from these shows. The All American executives told us they were under a tremendous financial crunch. To relieve this burden, they had asked the four executive producers to defer their salaries. Hasselhoff politely declined and demanded to be paid. The three remaining executive producers, Doug, Michael, and I, agreed. For 12 weeks, we went without our salaries, which at that time amounted to $10,000 a week each. 12 weeks later, All American called us again. It happened that the All American executives were flying from Los Angeles to New York. The Burke, Schwartz, Bonin team and our attorneys were gathered around the speakerphone in my office. After the usual preliminaries, Tony Scotti, head of All American, told us that the loan facility his company had set into place had fallen apart. Would we, Burke, Schwartz, and Bonin, agree to defer our salaries once more? After a brief exchange, our attorney, Peter DeCom, stepped up to the plate. Your first priority is to supply the show with cash. Write a fucking check out of your own checkbook. That's what this business is about. Had the air conditioning broken down? This distracting thought entered my consciousness as I felt a solitary bead of sweat course down my back. Peter DeCom is a tough player, as tough as his All-American opponents. Tony Scotti had probably been thinking, Burke, Schwartz, and Bonin went for it once. Maybe they'll go for it again. That's what All American is here for. They're supposed to cash flow the business. Otherwise, you could do Baywatch without All American. They'll pay you. They must pay you. DeCom was right. All American, it turned out, did have the money, or at least access to it. They just didn't want to write the check. It was that simple. Good, clean, capitalistic, hardball stuff. All American never forgave Leah Brackeen and Peter DeCom. They still don't like Leah, although it's been so long, they can't remember why.